See if I can film myself spinning some flax today. I got it set up on my Jensen Tina 2, and this is my first time using a Strick, first time using the distaff, but so far so good. It is getting a little tangly, but so far so good. I don't, it's kind of brittle, but it is a fairly humid day, and I've been kind of using a little spit too. Hey, it works. So here goes. Took me a while to get my wheel calibrated to where I could spin. You know, I had to get just the right amount of take up. And it took, I don't know, I want to say it took me about 30 minutes. So those first few yards of yarn probably would be pretty crappy. But so far, so good. I'm getting a nice thread. It actually works pretty well once you get your rhythm going. I almost don't want to stop because this is a little different than spinning wool, because I need to keep my fingers further back because of the drafting zone. The fiber is fairly long, so it is kind of a different rhythm. And it takes me a while to get into that rhythm, so it's probably best that I don't go back and forth. Can't really see my other wheel in this shot. I guess that's a good thing. But I have my Kromsky Sonata. It's got some wool on it. And I was just working on that, so that probably also slowed me down with getting my rhythm for spinning my flax. But hey, I'm spinning. And this wheel, oh my goodness, it actually sat for years. I haven't used it very much. I bought it because I thought it was just a work of art. It is just so beautiful, the cherry wood and the workmanship. It is just a well-made wheel, and I could tell it's just made, you know, one wheel at a time. And so I love it. And I'm just today realizing just how great it is to spin on. It really is nice. I mean, it just spins by itself. I think it's because of the way it's balanced. But I could go for hours. I probably will go for hours because it took me so long to get started. So I'm probably going to keep on going. This is spinning up fairly quickly, so there you go, spinning flat on my Jensen Tina. Cha-ching.